Are we living in a simulation? Would we even know if we were? So I think most likely not. So today we are looking at Nick Bostrom's theory of this mind-bending topic. Many works of science fiction and forecast predicts that an enormous amount of computing power will be available in the future. So let's suppose that these predictions are correct. So one thing that later generations might do with their super powerful computers is to run detailed simulations of their ancestors or people like their ancestors, because their computers will be so powerful they could run many such simulations.
Suppose that these simulated people are conscious, then it could be the case that the vast majority of minds like ours do not belong to the original race, but rather to the people simulated by the advanced descendants of an original race. It is then possible to argue that if this were the case, we would be rational to think that we are likely among the simulated minds, rather than among the original biological ones. Therefore, if we don't think that we are currently living in a computer simulation, we are not entitled to believe that we have descendants who will run lots of simulations of their ancestors. Okay, so I tried to make like a graphical explanation of this. So we start on top here, like you see, the birth of a civilization was year one, then time goes on and they reach technological maturity in year 14,050. So then they can approach to the next level, which is starting to simulate all of the years and the people who had died and all of their ancestors previously to this year. So then we can have a look at the runtime of the civilization, like if they started from year one and that's the birth of the civilization, then they run this simulation all the way up to year 14,050. I guess we would be like, if we are in a simulation now, I guess we would be like around here somewhere in 2022, so who knows.
So that is the basic idea of the theory. Now let's dive a bit deeper in. The theory is based on that one of three propositions is true. But first, I just want to clarify what we mean by the term technological maturity.
Technological maturity in this theory means where humankind has acquired most of the technological capabilities that one can currently show to be consistent with physical laws and with material and energy constraints. Such a mature stage of technological development will make it possible to convert planets and other astronomical resources into enormously powerful computers.
Then let's have a look at the three propositions.
All civilizations at our current stage of technological development go extinct before they reach technological maturity. There is a very strong convergence among all technological mature civilizations that they all lose interest in creating simulations of their ancestors. Ancestor simulations is a very detailed computer simulation of people who used to live. So detailed that the simulations would be conscious. The last proposition is that we are almost certainly living in a simulation.
If the first proposition is false, that means that a civilization in the future or the past did reach technological maturity. And if the second proposition also is false, meaning that a fraction of the civilization who did reach technological maturity do use some of the resources for the purpose of creating ancestor simulations, then we can mathematically show that the number of people with our kind of experiences that will be living inside these ancestor simulations will be vastly greater than the number of people that will be living in an unmeditated original history. So, as just a reference, in 2022, it is estimated that 109 billion people from our civilization have existed. So, if we do some quick math, we end up with 94% of our civilization having lived and died.
So, that means that the vast majority of people will be simulated rather than non-simulated. And on that condition, you're most likely to be one of the simulated people, just based on probability. So there are more people that have lived and died than that have original histories. So the theory is that if you don't believe in the first two propositions, you will have to believe that the third one is real and that you're most likely living in a computer simulation right now. To expand a bit more on this theory, we just take a look at how likely it is that a technological mature civilization will use some computing power resources to produce an astronomical number of ancestor simulations. This comes from a comparison between the estimate of the kind of computing power that a technological mature civilization will be able to master by converting planets into structures optimized for computing, and on the other hand, estimate how much computing power that is required to simulate one human brain, and therefore simulate all human brains that have ever existed. Of course, we don't have any exact values for this, but we can set the lower bound on the amount of computing power a mature civilization would have. Then we can estimate roughly the amount of computing power it would take to simulate the whole of human history. And this estimate is the amount of the available computing power, and the required computing power needed to simulate human history differ by a vast number of order of magnitude, such that using only 1% of the compute power available of one planetary sized computer, even just for 1 minute, would enable you to create millions of runs of all of human history.
So, to sum this up, if we believe that one of the three propositions is true, then the theory could support that we are living in a simulation. So, I hope you found this as mind-boggling as I do. It's a really interesting theory to think about. So if you want to read more about this, I have left a link to Nick Bostrom's paper in the description below. So what do you think about this simulation theory? Let me know in the comments below, and don't forget to check out this video, and see you in the next one.